Live, Eye on the Desert from CBS Local 2.
Welcome to Eye on the Desert. I'm Rob Bradley, and tonight for Patrick Evans, thanks for joining us. We've got a great show in store, including a sitting down with a local author. But we start tonight with an in-depth tour at a Palm Desert art gallery. Heather James Fine Arts is in the process of hanging a new exhibition called Celebration of the Masters that includes some very important pieces of art. Four paintings by Monet, a Picasso, a remarkable John Singer Sargent, and a Jackson Pollock drip painting will be on display. These paintings are normally only seen in museums or in books. Eye on the Desert photojournalist Joel Aponte has more on the new exhibit.
My name's Chip Tom, and I'm the curator at Heather James Fine Art here in Palm Desert, California. We are now in Gallery 1, which is part of our Celebrating the Masters exhibition for the holidays. And in Gallery 1, we have the masters from the 20th century. I'm standing next to a Robert Rauschenberg combine sculpture. Combine meaning it's part sculpture, part painting. This is a historical and self-autobiographical piece. And it's a combine of, again, the painting and the sculpture. The other piece that I wanted to talk about in this room is by Andy Warhol, who was all about commercialism and anything could be art, was asked by BMW to design one of their race cars. And so he submitted two different designs. BMW actually ended up going with the other design, but this is the maquette and the one-of-a-kind Andy Warhol hand-designed BMW car from the 1980s. So we are now in Gallery 2. The star of the Apex Expressionist exhibition in Gallery 2 is to my right here. This is the Jackson Pollock number 21 painting from 1950. And it is an exquisite example of the perfect time period of Jackson Pollock's abstract expressionist paintings. In the mid to late 40s and in the 50s, the art world moved from Europe to New York. And Jackson Pollock was a part of a movement of this abstract expressionist artist that really put America and Europe on the map. It was a very exciting time. It was a new art form. No one had ever seen this type of art before. What we have in the other side is the response then. Once this had been around for 20 years, this became the norm. And after, instead of abstract expressionism, it was going to more abstract minimalism, it was going to be quieter, it was more about the Zen. He cares for me. So now we're in Gallery 3, and this is the gallery space that actually welcomes our guests when they first come to the gallery. I'm having the opportunity to exhibit emerging artists in this space. So in this room, we have two pieces by an artist named Johnny Swing, and they are chairs that are sculpted from Kennedy silver half dollars. Although they look imposing and uncomfortable, they are actually quite comfortable to sit in and can go either inside or outside. And I've paired them with two sculptures by more classical artists. One is an Yves Klein International Blue coffee table with the dry pigment. And the other is here is a George Rickey kinetic sculpture. With the slightest breeze, they stay in action for quite a while. This is now Gallery 4, and this is really the heart of the Celebrating the Masters exhibition. We're really incredibly proud to be able to present to the Valley it's such important impressionist paintings that we have in here. We have a painting that captures this quintessential essence of the impressionist movement, and that is Monet's House of the Customs Agent. In this, we have a small house that is next to the seashore. In this painting, he is capturing the shimmering white caps of the ocean, and also how the brush strokes capture the changing light in the house and garden itself. We also have a wall of old master paintings. These are various European painters all living in Italy in the Renaissance times. And he keeps it out of sight. Sometimes we go to see a great play or a great movie, and visually it was very impactful. But we go home, and it makes us think past our visit to the gallery, for example. Take home something with them that they'll remember. And maybe in some small way, make them think about something differently or look at something differently.
The gallery is located on Portola Avenue in Palm Desert. You can find out more on their website, heatherjames.com.